Hey, welcome once again to my channel. This is Hans Perm, and today we will have a recording once again, but this time you will going to notice I'm having a keyboard in front of me. I used to do it in my previous video na I'm using an electric guitar, pero para maiba naman, no? We will be might be doing the same stuff. How can we record music using a DAW or a digital audio workstation? But last time I think I have used a different DAW using an Audacity. So ngayon naman, this time we will going to use a waveform, right? So isa din tong magandang digital audio workstation. So ganito itsura niya. Basically it's free siya. At pwede niyong i-download, mag-register lang kayo, and then they will provide you a link and it will notify you on your email. And then yeah, so talaga napaka professional ang approach ng waveform na DAW. Okay, so punta tayo dito mamaya. Right. So this time what I done is I just put my keyboard in front of me. Ito. I'm using a Yamaha S 900, no, PSR S 900. Kasi basically it's a workstation also. So there is a new version of this one, I think using SX. Pero this one is pretty old na, but still maganda pa rin ang articulation niya. So what we did, we connect this keyboard directly straight to my mixer. So which means kinabit ko siya sa isang channel along with my condenser mic, of course, separate channel as well. And then yung output natin is a stereo. So tinurn off ko muna yung PA speaker ko kasi para hindi mag-feedback. So we just connect it straight from our PC again using that analog signal straight to a 3.5 mm. So nag-line in feed once again tayo. So I'm still waiting for my audio interface. So excited na ako, pero let's do the usual connection for the meantime. Just I said, if you have fine tuning naman pagdating sa signals nyo, so at least it will going to be an audible output naman, right? So what we're going to work this time is we'll record, of course we're going to record, and we're going to use a digital audio workstation na waveform. So hindi ko na lang papakita paano install or download, but as long as you know how to do your setup. Of course, normally this is very common in every DAW. At least you have to set the audio device type. Either you're using only a Windows, or probably you're using also some other driver like ASIO or para sa Yamaha connection or Direct Sounds. Pero for now, I will be using a Windows audio. This is the same thing we did also in Audacity, no? Ang output natin, okay, pwedeng gagamit muna ako ng speaker, but if you have an audio interface, a driver device will appear here. You could also use that one as your output device, but we will going to use either a headphone, right? Anyhow, wala pa tayo nun. So what I did for the meantime, kinabit ko muna siya sa speaker, right, ng computer itself. Okay, ang pinaka-importante, since we are converting, we are sending our analog signal coming straight from our mixer, of course, ginawa ko muna siyang line in. Right, para kahit paano pulido ang pasok. So, pre-amplified na siya. So, kasi may mga EQs tayo, saka effects. So, alright, so this time, of course, nakita nyo dito, I have different list there. Right, so I think Ito kasi sa camera ko to, saka sa built-in. But same thing also if you have an audio interface device, it will also appear here. Like Scarlett, right? Yung mamahalin na audio interface, right? Okay, so that's it. If a pretty decent sound, I think 48 megahertz or 48,000 hertz is fine enough. Kasi ano naman to? At least 16. Actually, ito ay tumatakbo na to ng 24-bit equivalent eh. Pero yung iba pa nga, binababaan pa nila. So they make it maybe 32, ranging from 32. Alright. But this is fine for 48 hertz as long as your sliders, you're not reaching the peak, right? Beyond the zero, or at least huwag tayong lumampasan para hindi siya maging distorted ang tunog. Tapos yung sample rate 19 is for 480 sample, right? So yung iba 300 plus, right? Yeah, this is only what we need to configure, but then if you see how a waveform should start first, actually lahat meron siyang mga step by step how to start or set up everything before you start on recording. Alright, so ang gagawin po natin, okay, let's create a new project. So I will make this project as let's say worship song. Right, I will name this one as worship song, and this is will be my location. Okay, I will create the project. Right, so meron na siyang mga automatic tracks. Basically, you will see some automatic tracks there. At these tracks are basically pwede mo i-set in different channel. You could have a simultaneous tracks, but since I'm only having one signal mix on na kagad coming into my computer, of course, single track lang. Otherwise, again, kung meron tayong audio interface, at least minimum of two channels, so simultaneous, we can do that. Actually, we can do that multiple channels as well, pero not at the same time. It will go into one at a time. Right, itong track na to, I will name this one as, let's say, keyboard. Right. Keyboard, right. So, mamaya siguro, sa-separate ko yung vocals. Ilalagay ko dito yung vocals. Pero, sige, pwede kong i-play muna yung keyboard. So, makikita nyo na kagad doon. Fini-feed nyo na kagad yung aking voice. Even if I strike the piano. Yan. So at least nakikita nyo na yung setup natin kanina, it's already correctly set. So technically, nakapasok siya lahat dito. Dito sa channel na to. So pero pwede ako magsabay. Right. So in waveform, if you want to record now this one, you have to engage this record. Narinig ko konti ang aking output kasi output ko ay nasa computer. Right. So, babaan natin konti para hindi siya mag-feedback. Yeah. So, pag in-engage na yun. So, say for example, I'm going to record. Right. I will record now. One of the worship song na entitled Be With You by City Harvest Church. Sige. So, I will going to engage this and then I will start the recording here at the bottom. So sample muna. So turn off ko. Actually, dapat I have to turn off the microphone kasi technically maingay dito sa room. nanonood ng TV yung anak ko. Alright, so let's listen this one. I'll be using the output of my computer. So, sample muna. So, okay. Yun. So, narinig niyo yun. Hopefully, na-feed niyo yun. I'm not using an headphone for monitor. Pero this time, let's do it correctly na. And I will turn off muna yung ating mixer para hindi maghising muna. Okay. So I will delete this one first. Right. Let me turn off the mic. So, I already recorded. Sana nakuha ng maganda. Kaya lang may konting mali ako dun. Alright. Let's try to listen it. Listen natin yung record. Yeah. Actually, pwede ko pa namang taasan. Right, yung gain. Yeah, so far it's okay na. Tingnan natin dun sa may strings. Siguro dito yata. Ayun, so meron na siyang string. So nakuha yung string natin. Right. So there you go. So nakapag-record tayo ng isang layer. So which means pwede sigurong lagyan natin to ng vocals. Okay. baba muna natin yung keyboard. Alright, so gagawa tayo ng isang track dito. Pero kailangan kong, I need to hear this track. Pwedeng, huwag marami ng track, actually pwede kong i-click yung solo dito. I-engage natin yung solo. Right. But anyhow, nag-iisa pa lang naman. So gagawin ko naman itong isa as my vocals. I-rename natin as a vocals. Vocals, right. Mapapansin nyo, you notice that my key is parang mataas, no? Matinis. Technically, I transpose that key of G into 4. I transpose it para makanta ko siya ng parang kinanta ko yata sa B or B flat. So para pang lalaki kasi babae ang kumanta nun. So let me try to now to record. To record now this another track. So actually pwede ka pa rin mag-add ng track pag more than 8 tracks you dito eh. And then later, we will try to save this one, how to save this file in the waveform. And we could also try to export it to WAV or MP3. Right, so this time, let's try to sing along with that recorded first track keyboard. Right, so let me just open up my lyrics. Okay, so let's try this. Again, I need to engage. This one, you don't need to engage this one now. All I have to do is to engage this vocals. Right? So let's try.
Soul, I confide in you through all my darkest moments. In you will find my peace, my comfort when I'm weak. I trust in you through storm and raging sea. Faithful, you're my God. You are glory and the lifter of my head. Your light it fills my days. Please be in your ways. Forever I surrender all to you. And I live to worship you, my Jesus, you're the only one for me. Nothing will ever take your place, my precious Savior. Who can stand between my Lord and me? Lord, I live to honor you, and I long to bring my life as an offering. Take me higher, draw me deeper. I give it all to be with you.
Yun, there you go. So it was recorded and hopefully it will be a good... Actually, you're hearing that one now. Let me just want to listen to that record. Maybe I will start here with some vocals now.
Savior of my soul.
Right, so mataas. Pansin ko mataas yung fields natin. So pwede ko naman baba ang konti. Gawin natin negative 3. So napansin nyo, meron effects yung aking voice. So totally, I'm not adding this digitally in DAO. So which means these are all been, it was all been recorded straight from the setting of my 12 channel mixer. Right, so far, okay naman siya. So, siguro magtaas lang konti ako dito sa piano. And siguro ibalik ko na lang sa zero. Right, so may kita niyo naman sa wave, mataas-taas eh, ang signal. So, sa condenser mic natin kasi naka-full yata. And then, so mataas yung gain ko. Right, so how can we save this one? So I'll just save this project straight from my file, save as an edit. And I will just save it from my desktop. So gonna, well, the name will gonna be Worship Song Edit 2. If I save this one, that's it. So pwede akong bumalik dito and add some more tracks. And let's try to oh no. Let's try to export this one by rendering to a file. And particularly the settings, actually tanggalin muna na engagement doon. The settings actually you will the file rendered would be a save format into MP3. Okay, tapos gagawin ko siyang stereo and pwede ko din save siya as wave, right? So sa ngayon you're not seeing this saving on my screen, pero pakinggan natin mamaya yung tunog niya. Right, so I think I have already saved it. I can close now this audio interface, and ang hindi ko lang matandaan yata saan ko siya sinave. Okay, andito na naman tayo. So, alright, let me reopen. I think it's in default. Naka-save siya sa documents. I think meron siyang, oh yeah, worship song, I think. And import, exported. Ayun, andito siya. So, I found it already. So, ayan, napakita ko sa screen. So, if I open this one now, by default, my media player is, you are definitely hearing this one kasi yung akin desktop audio is nakakabit dito ngayon. Alright. So, taasan natin konti. So far, maganda yung quality niya. Yeah, maganda yung quality niya. So, pag i-check natin yung capacity nito, is, ano din siya? Ay, may sumigaw pa sa background. So, 1.3 megabytes. Alright. So, and I think this is pretty audible now kasi yung volume lang ng computer ko is halfway lang. Right? So, that's a bit good now, right? Right. Okay. So, this time, at least we have completely demonstrate and how to work with DAO. And, of course, we can still add on some more instrument there. But really, to tell you frankly, I'm very excited also to have my audio interface. Hindi ko muna i-reveal kung ano yung audio interface na kinuha ko or in order ko. But the thing is, we have much more better control, I think. Kasi sa audio interface itself, merong pa siyang preamp. So, and then totally I could record two simultaneously two tracks actually, and I can still connect to my mixer. So both equipments really have a preamp, so really it's much more better, right? So that would be it. So thank you for tuning in, and I really want to see you once again on my next video, and God bless. Bye bye for now.